Hi, I'm Peter Travers, a movie critic for Rolling Stone, and I am fresh from paying for my ticket and going to see the movie Paramount Pictures thought critics shouldn't see. And I don't know why. I don't know why. The movie is called G.I. Joe, The Rise of Cobra. And since Paramount just made $389 million on Transformers 2, they must know there's a market for big, loud, and galactically stupid. And you know what, people? They've done it again. Paramount has done it again. They've taken this Hasbro toy of G.I. Joe, played in the film by Channing Tatum, and made a movie that, I'm sorry to say, I can't say it, is just not as bad as Transformers 2, but is, I assure you, a colossal waste of time, a colossal oppression on your brain power. You know, I sat in an audience this morning. I went really early, and there were at least a dozen people online. So that made me happy because I thought, well, maybe no one's going to really go. I know it's a wonderful, beautiful sunny morning here in New York, but I'm thinking, maybe you people know. Maybe you've seen the trailer. Because if you have, you could see the big set piece given away in which the G.I. Joes, and they're all Joes, if any of you are out there are so out of it and benighted to not know that it's not just one G.I. Joe, but it's an elite core from all kinds of nationalities, just the best, who can come in and give you a war toy and bring it to life. But the evil villains, run by a Scotsman named McCullen, played by Christopher Eccleston, his thing is to start to destroy the world with what he calls nanomites. And these look to me, when I first saw them, like they were little cockroaches. But the fact is, they're not. They turn into some kind of green slime that looks like a special effect left over from Ghostbusters, which, as you know, the green slime was a long time ago. They made these Ghostbusters movies. It just looks tacky. They spent $170 million to do green slime from Ghostbusters. The Eiffel Tower just has a little thing that goes, psh, and green slime falls, and it falls down. No. I think even people that like Transformers 2 expect a little more from their special effects. And what would I expect as a critic? Would I expect acting? Well, Channing Tatum, who was so good last year in Stop Loss, doesn't do any acting. Sienna Miller, who plays the Baroness, a villain who wears a nice black jumpsuit and basically a black wig. I don't think she dyed her hair. It looks like a wig to me. I got the feeling the actors knew what they were doing and decided to disguise themselves. Joseph Gordon-Levitt, who you could see this weekend because his really good summer movie, 500 Days of Summer, opens wide this weekend, is practically in disguise through the whole movie. I can't say anything more because it's a spoiler, but like we don't know, like we didn't look at the cartoon series. But tacky special effects, bad acting, horrendous script. The direction is by Stephen Sommers, who gave us the Mummy Trilogy, people, the Mummy Trilogy, and that classic Van Helsing. Remember that with Hugh Jackman killing vampires? Awful, 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 and you get awful, awful, awful again. So why am I kind of letting this one off of the Transformers 2 hook? Because I think Michael Bay, when he made Transformers, is a smart enough guy to know that he was shoveling crap into our multiplex and saying, you know, you people, he's cynical. He looks at us and he says, you'll buy any kind of crap if it looks like a toy or something else. So I'm going to feed you crap. That's bitter and cynical. I think the people who made this movie are too stupid to know what they were doing. You know, it's as if they just bumbled into this crap and foisted it upon us. Now, should you see it for any reason? God knows. But I think there's a cure. I think if you see this, you go to Netflix or wherever you get your videos and you look for a 2004 movie called Team America World Police, animated, done by the South Park guys, Matt Stone and Trey Parker. They did this perfectly. They even had a theme song called America, Fuck Yeah, you know, to just get that whole warmongering, let's have toys that kill people, let's just make this entertainment for the summer. Go see that and you'll see what fools they are. Did not the people who made G.I. Joe see Team America World Police and realize how stupid they were being? I don't think so. But I want to give great credit here as we decide to put G.I. Joe in the scum bucket, which we're still naming after Transformers 2. But this guy's going in. He is going and having really pride of place after Transformers 2, because there's no movie after Transformers that is stupider than G.I. Joe. But I want to give credit to the guy who sat in front of me at this morning's screening. There were at least 600 seats, but he chose to sit directly in front of me. I don't know why, but I appreciated it because I could feel his pain. And right before the end of the movie, when the big reveal happens, the guy had had enough. He got up from his seat, took off the baseball cap he was wearing, looked at me in a kind of contemptuous, why are you sitting here thing, and said, ah, shit. Well, people, the public speaks. I couldn't have said it better. And I'm Peter Travers.